Give me a second here. Okay.
I think. Oh, it's time go. For all right, so we're doing video game violence and how it, and if it causes children to become violent, basically. And we are against it, so we don't think that video games cause violence in youth. So we feel that basically interactions with, when a child interacts with video games, it really doesn't correlate with any of their present or future violent emotions and actions that they may show. Video games themes and objectives do not really represent actions and feelings of a real child. A child can tell what's fantasy and what's real. The game is only like a form of the entertainment, and I think that's super clear. And when a child participates in an activity, just like when they participate in like guns and like robbers and cops and robbers, or you know, cowboys and Indians, that sort of thing, they understand that it's a game. You know, of anyone in the world, I think children understand the difference between a fantasy world and basically the real world. So, not only that, when a child participates in a video game, they may feel a little bit frustrated because of it, but that doesn't mean that frustration equals violence. So that's, I feel, my first opening statement.
Yeah, and we're going to be going through a bunch of statistics showing the correlation between sales and violence. And we'll talk about a lot of real issues that actually cause aggression and violence in children rather than just them playing a game. So, come in.
You guys done?
Yeah.
Okay.
All right.
Ready? Go.
So I'm taking the stance that violent video games kind of, it does have a negative connotation on children. Reason for my position is that the producers that produce the game even know that because they have a rating on the game. Like some games come rated teen for teenagers or R for 18 and over. I would say that the reason also I think it has a negative connotation on kids is because they're playing it for long hours. Some video games, you're encouraged to kill and then get skill points for that. So then like it gives you more of an incentive to go about that emotion, kind of have even less empathy for people within the game, which can even transfer into real life. I'm going to, as the debate goes on, I'll show some real life examples in which way people have shown that it has a connection with kids showing violent behavior in real life.
So to begin our argument, I wanted to first kind of start on video game violence has been such a negative thing the last like 20 or 30 years, but video games didn't start as being violent, you know. So if you take an example of Pong, like in the early 70s when video games started to become super popular, Pong was released in 1972, but like the first real controversial violent video game like topic didn't come about until around 1976 when a violent video game was released. So if you take into, like if you're kind of on the point or on the side of video games cause violence, it doesn't really make sense because there were video games all through the early 70s and basically they were very like lighthearted games like Pong and just different like Asteroids. I guess Asteroids is a little violent, but no one really came about, you know, bringing up this controversial topic. And there's actually, in the National Coalition Against Censorship, there's a statistic that actually shows that there was a game in 1976 taken off the market. It was called Death Race, and it was basically a racing game where you run over gremlins, and that kind of basically started the controversial topic only because there was a violent video game in the market, and it kind of made sense for everyone to put those two together when you know, they didn't use Pong as a violent, you know, example for violence in kids. So it just, it doesn't really make sense if you use that argument.
Okay, so if violent video games had an effect on children and caused them to become violent and therefore commit crimes, would it not follow that there would be a correlation between the number of video games sold and played and the number of crimes these children commit? If we're playing more games, we should be getting more aggressive and then becoming more violent, right? Well, a study done by the Entertainment Software Association disproves this theory. In 1996, video games sales were sitting around $2.5 billion in the U.S., and violent crimes were just under two million crimes. Then, at the end of their 10-year study in 2007, video game sales had increased to over $9.5 billion, but violent crimes had decreased to barely over 1.5 million. And the Department of Justice reports that in that time, the number of youthful offenders fell to less than half of what it was. That seems to disprove this theory, doesn't it? And that's because of 2 points. Number one, violent video games don't actually cause children to be violent. And two, the people who would normally be committing those crimes are not anymore because they are too busy playing the games. So in a way, video games are saving us from harm. Doctors Patrick Murkay and Christopher Ferguson wrote a book titled Moral Combat. In it, they do a study on this very issue, the correlation between video game sales and violent crimes. They discovered that the 20 countries where video games are most popular are among the safest in the world. Here's a quote for them. In fact, the three countries with the fewest global game sales had nearly 200% higher average violent crime rate than the three countries that sold the most games. According to Washington-based Intel Center, the countries you might want to avoid are Iraq, Nigeria, Somalia, Afghanistan, Lebanon, and Yemen, and these are among the most violent in the world. No one would ever suggest that the violence in these countries is due to Grand Theft Auto or Call of Duty, because we recognize that it can be traced back to political instability, religious and militant extremism, ongoing civil wars, famine, and corrupt governments.
So, to build on what Tegan was just saying, so let's pretend that we're going to kind of go on the side of that media or that video games do cause violence, okay? Let's say that that was actually something that existed. Let's look into the stats of that, okay? So let's look at all media as in general. So movies, books, TV, art, video games, okay? So in a massgeneral.org research assignment that they had, they released statistics on youth violence, and they came out with a stat that said that only 5% of youth are at risk of violent behavior. So if you correlate that with video game and media consumption, we'll take a look at how much of that media is consumed. So in a commonsensemedia.org research statistic assignment,
your 20 seconds is up.
What's that?
You had 20 seconds left when you started.
Oh, do we have another 2 minutes?
No,
it's no, four statements collectively.
Okay.
So it's back to Emmanuel for your four statements.
According to the American Psychological Association, they did a focus study on the link between violent video games violent video games and aggressive behavior, and the outcomes that they've done, the outcome that they've come up with is that it does have a correlation, because the kids that they had do the study on, they came out having verbal aggression, so the games have swear words, coming out like having like giving threats, because phrases have been popularized within some of the video games. Games like Grand Theft Auto, it's encouraged to steal cars, kill people, go on to do murder missions, rob banks, etc. And the way games have progressed now, they're more realistic. Like when you see the graphics, it's not like a cartoon 2D game or something, or even like Pong. It's not mere for just entertainment. It's more of it's real life. And so now I guess we're getting away from games that is supposed to be just for casual play or whatever. And now it's just getting too realistic, in my opinion. Which is why I feel like the video game producers, they're doing a good job in putting ratings on the games, but then the topic is now, they're not as easy, they're more easily accessible than before. Before, when you go to, say, EB Games or like Blockbuster, you have to show ID before you get your game. Now, on PSN or Xbox or whatever, all you just have to do is lie about your age and it's downloaded. And parents are not really being, they're not really watching over the kids on like what they're doing or what they're downloading, because it's like when you get the Xbox or whatever, you assume that it's just a game and that they're just playing it for whatever recreational purposes, but they're not really taking action of what games they're downloading and the parental views on the game. CNN also did a report on an 18-year-old gunman who killed 9 people in Germany. They did a raid on his place and found he had a lot of violent video games like Call of Duty, Grand Theft Auto. Then they were doing a study on Gears of War. And they were doing a study to see if they had any kind of correlation. And I mean, of the American Psychological Association, they've kind of have like proof on how it's not coincidence, basically. I would agree.
Is there 4 points?
Yep.
Okay, now we have a minute break before we get into the open debates. Yeah, time for that. I'll be right back.
Who's going first for this, you guys, eh?
What?
You guys are going first for this?
I think so.
Or is it? It's an open debate, right. Am I supposed to keep on, like, just switching back and forth?
Yeah, that's what I did.
Yeah, all right. Okay.
Good to go?
It's all good. Yep, we're good.
Okay.
Let me
know
when. How long do we
have?
You
have 5 minutes of open discussion.
Then. 3, 2, 1, you're on.
So just to kind of go against one of the last things you said there, Emmanuel. So you did mention that when they raided that guy's house, who was a shooter, right? They actually raided his house and found violent video games. But if you take account of the example, Adam Lanza, he was actually the guy responsible for Sandy Hook, like one of the worst school shootings ever. They actually raided his house and his journals and all this stuff, and they took record of kind of all the people he associated with. It turns out he was going to the same arcade every single day for hours at a time, and guess what game he was playing? Dance Dance Revolution. so if you take that into account, and if that sort of, if you say violent video games causes violence, Dance Dance Revolution is like the least violent video game, so it doesn't really make sense.
But you're also playing Call of Duty, Dead Alive, and Grand Theft Auto.
But that's not what he spent all his time doing.
The most time he spent was on Dance Dance Revolution.
He spent 10 hours a day. They would have to pull the plug and kick him out at like 3 in the morning.
Mm-hmm.
So he had the games, but he played the other one.
Mm-hmm. I would want to ask you about the sales correlation versus the violence, like the statistic that you you brought up. I would ask, who was buying the games?
Does it matter if a child buys it or if a parent buys it for their child?
But then that's we're debating on kids playing the games.
Exactly.
So like I said, the games that are being rated says 18 and over, right? We play video games.
Mm-hmm.
How do you know it's not us who is buying the games? I don't know, it's not more of us that was playing the video games, which doesn't relate to the statistics that you brought up.
No, that's statistics for everybody. And they even mentioned that, right here, that the youthful offenders go down as well.
But it didn't give the age demographic, did it?
So there is a different demographic, though, that's even more important, though. Like, so if you keep that, like, point in mind, with the youth stuff, that if you took, there's a stat that actually, what is it? It's a BuzzFeed thing. Sorry, Tech Addiction. They did a study and they actually found out that Japan and China actually play the most mobile games altogether combined in all of the world. Okay, their kills by firearms per 100,000 people is 0.7. The U.S. is 10 per 100,000 people. But they were playing more video games. So all in all, between children, parents, anyone, it doesn't matter who was buying them, who was playing them. They were playing just more than all of the U.S. combined. And their firearm deaths were way less than the U.S. So it just doesn't, the statistics do not really match up.
But you said Japan, right?
Yeah, Japan and China.
Yeah, what video game were they playing?
Mobile games. So any and every mobile game, including violent ones. And there's also
because I want to know, is it mostly like Dance Dance Revolution, or is it like Pong, like e-games or R games? That's what I kind of wanted to know.
Okay, well, on that point, a study done by Psychology Today, a Dr. Kunter and Dr. Olson. Here's a quote from their book. They first set out to establish what behaviors are normal for young adolescents, including the role of video games in their life. They found a correlation between boys playing mature-rated games and certain aggressive acts and other behavioral issues. However, they also found that those who played no video games at all were more likely to exhibit these behaviors. Ultimately, they concluded that violent video games are an easy scapegoat to blame rather than the other major factors that are in effect on children's behavior. So it doesn't matter whether it's violent or not, even the kids that don't play games at all are more violent than the ones that do play games.
So to kind of also answer your question as well, like that's to build on top of that point, what I was building earlier in my second argument is there's a site that actually did a research, Common Sense Media. They actually took a kind of general census of how much of each medium is violence. So, and they actually came out a fact that 50 to 60% of games are violent, they said, around average. So that kind of answers your question. So all games that are played, basically 50 to 60% of them are violent. So it doesn't really matter. You're looking at about half the games are being violent. So if you take into account, like, if they say movies, 91% of movies contain violence.
Time's up. Okay. Open debate is closed, so now you have a break before your closing statements. You have 1 minute.
Okay.
group will be going next. We need one more group to go this morning.
It's a lot of fun.
Get it over with. Uh-huh. You gotta go out there today. The next day, go out to Jaws Jaws.
Yeah, we'll go.
You guys will go?
Oh.
Okay.
I mean, we're the only group with everybody here, I think.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah, so he gets... No, we close first.
You got a minute?
Oh, that's right.
Yeah.
Okay.
3, 2, 1, go.
So, just in closing, we think that violence is all around us. We see it like every day in movies, TV, music, and video games, and many other things. But just because the violence is around us doesn't give us a reason to blame aggressive and violent actions on something else. So, like, video games are nothing more than an expression of art in an interactive form. So when it comes down to it, it's up to us to raise our children and ourselves under an ethical and moral code that does not put up with any violence as an answer.
See, and violence has always existed. How many wars have we had? And there's been racial profiling and terrorism and everything. We're not going to say that Hitler started a war because he played Call of Duty. He didn't. He started it because he had his own problems with upbringing and other emotional issues that he had. So to say that playing a game makes our kids turn into killers and violent people is actually us not understanding that a game is just a game, it's not real. I think kids are a whole lot smarter than that, than what people think they are by saying that it does.
Yeah, just to finally close it out, the fact that we ourselves are in control of what we consume, you know, it's we're putting the blame on other things. For all we're putting the blame on guns or violence or different things. We need to take accountability of ourselves and who we raise and who we surround ourselves with. And we can't just blame them on the mediums that are, there's always gonna be mediums, so it's just up to us to create that code and to stick with it.
My final conclusion would be that it's not, I'm of the stance that violence does not come from video games, but violent video games does have an effect on kids who do play those video games and produce violent behavior. Because of some parents are negligent to have parental discretion in what they purchase and what they consume, you don't have that guidance of I wouldn't say that kids are smart enough to know whether or not a video game is what not to take into real life consideration, because like they are not of the stance to make their own decisions. Even like when it comes to like court, like there's a reason why parents will have to take a stance for them before they reach 18. And so it is up to the parents to take responsibility of showing, I guess, of them take the responsibility of them consuming whatever games that they play and making sure that they know what is right from wrong. But then what my stance is that if they don't have that kind of guidance or whatever, because parents are negligent to just say that, I'll categorize all video games as Pong, Grand Theft Auto as Pong, like Call of Duty as Pong, like it's not beneficial for you just to take it as just a game or as face value. I would back up with saying that it does have a psychological behavior. The video games do have psychological behavior on people, on the kids, but it's up to the parents raising them to kind of like guide them and show them like it's divided from real life situation and fake.
Okay, thanks.